Hello, my name is Salma St. John. Welcome to Mushroom Culinary Arts, where mushrooms are the stars in everything we do here. Mushroom recipes, preservation methods, culinary history, health benefits, research, and much, much more. Today we are going to make a mushroom phyllo pie. Are adding also some chicken, although it can be also made vegetarian with just a different combination of mushrooms. I'm starting here on medium heat skillet. I'm adding my olive oil and bay leaf, and I am going to saute the onion, thinly cut onion. And here is the bay leaf, and I'm adding the shiitake mushroom cut into pieces, and these are cleaned and thoroughly washed and dried in a towel, a paper towel. And when the liquid is absorbed, I'm adding also my frozen mushrooms. And adding salt and pepper. So it will take a few minutes for the liquid to be absorbed, so I'm checking to see if the liquid is absorbed. Not yet. So a couple more minutes, and when it's absorbed, I'm adding my garlic. I didn't add it at the beginning so that it doesn't brown and burn. So now the liquid is completely gone, and at this point I'm gonna add to that. The next step is to add some wine and the spices. So here's the wine. Think about 2 tablespoons if I the recipe is available, and you can check the exact amounts. And now I'm adding my spices, and they are a combination of fennel, rosemary, and oregano, paprika, and I think that's about it. Italian combination of spices. I will let these mingle with the mushrooms for a minute, and then I'm gonna move these to a dish and let them cool so that I can use them in the filling. And here is the magic of the camera. So they are all moved now to the dish so that they can be room temp before using. Now I'm moving to make the second part of the filling, which is the chicken. And I'm using here chicken tenders. And I'll begin by using here's minced, like a couple of tablespoons of minced onion. I don't like to use big pieces. I use that with the mushrooms already, so we don't need too much onion. This will give it just some flavor. So I brown that a little, not brown, but just sweat it. And then I'm adding my chicken tenders cut and cleaned with salt and flour and water very well, and to take the poultry smell and taste. And then I'm adding my bay leaf and sauteing. Again, it's simple and you get the picture here. We are just adding the spices and sauteing it until all, salting and pepper, and sauteing this for the liquid to be absorbed. Now I'm adding the spices, Now you can see the liquid is absorbed and the chicken starts to be golden. Adding the garlic, the minced garlic, and just make the garlic mix a little bit with the flavor. Turn the heat off. And today I had from my garden some fresh basil. Since the spices are Italian, I'm gonna add just a few fresh leaves here to give it some aroma. Again, I'm gonna move this to a dish and let it also sit for a while until I prep my phyllo. And the phyllo is frozen. I get it at Whole Foods, and it should be actually sitting in your fridge for a couple of days before you use it to thaw. And also you need to put it on your countertop in the kitchen before you use it for 2 to 3 hours to be ready. Now I'm going to cut. I'm using today a round dish. However, if you have actually a rectangular dish, you can use that and you can use a whole full sheet instead of using cutting it into pieces. So I'm covering after I made my rounds to fit the dish. I'm covering that with a towel and I'm spraying some water very lightly to keep it moist. Here's my ghee, and I'm skimming the top of the ghee to throw away. And basically you put 1 tablespoon of the butter in your toaster oven or oven until it starts to brown, and you skim the top. I'm adding to that a quarter cup of the olive oil, good quality olive oil, and here's my organic feta cheese. And to the oil also I added 1 tablespoon, it's in the recipe, of the coconut oil. And we will not use all this oil, and actually we'll probably use less than half, and we'll use it for the rest of the dough. And it's very light, and it's very, very healthy. Healthy oils, at least. Now I look and see how many phyllo sheets we have, and I am dividing this. Bear in mind, I'm using only half of this phyllo. So, and I'm also using the half of that, of the half, to put the under the filling, and the other half to top the filling. And of course, in between, I'm gonna lightly brush with my oil. I'm adding now the feta cheese. And as I said, I use organic feta cheese, and it's actually delicious. And just use quality, not very salty. I added my mushrooms and my chicken, and I'm using some Parmigiano on top. And then I'm adding the other layers, and also separated by brushing, lightly brushing. And you can add also the trims that I have here on the side. You can add that, there will be no problem, but you can also make something else with it later on. I am pressing very lightly and brushing the top, and I'm going to also cut it, because if I wait until I bake it, it's gonna be broken into pieces because it's very fragile. And so I'm gonna use a very sharp knife to cut that into about 6 or 7 pieces, and cut it really, really well, and then bake in 350 degrees in the middle of the oven for about 20 to 25 minutes until it's completely golden. And now comes time to taste it, and it is mouth-watering. It's absolutely delicious, and it's one of my favorite. Now, here it is, and enjoy. Now let's talk a little bit about the shiitake mushroom, the star in this recipe. It has incredible benefits, health benefits and medicinal benefits. And it was it's a mushroom that is revered in Asia, particularly Japan. And it has so many good things beside, of course, the wonderful taste. And there is always some information added about the star mushroom that we use in the recipe. But the most important thing here is to pay attention to the rules. Never eat a mushroom that is not fully identified with certainty, and also eat a small amount. If you'd like to learn more about mushroom, join us, NAMA, or the North American Mycological Association. Simple and easy. Thanks for joining me, and see you in a different show.